Hi, welcome to the lecture number 8.1. In this lecture, I will teach you how to configure UART in polling mode and how to do a data type conversion for UART transmission. So, let's get started. After finishing this lecture, you will be able to configure UART transmitter and receiver in polling mode and convert integer and real number to string for UART transmission. As we know, UART stands for Universal Asynchronous Receiver Transmitter. UART is commonly used for interfacing between microcontroller and PC or microcontroller to another module. Because it is asynchronous, then there are only data lines, which are TX line for transmit and RX line for receive. UART is basically just a digital circuit that converts parallel data to serial data on the transmitter side and converts serial data to parallel data on the receiver side. This is the UART serial data frame. Each of the data frame can consist of 5 to 9 data bits with LSB first configuration. The commonly used data bits is 8 bits or 1 byte. When there is no data or idle condition, TX and RX line is always 1. And then there is a start bit and stop bit which are indicate where the first and the last data bit. The start bit is always 0 and the stop bit is always 1. The length of stop bit can be selected either 1, 1.5 or 2 bits. The parity bit is an optional bit that can be used to detect error. The parity bit can be even or odd parity. There are several standards for baud rate such as 9.6 kilobit per second or 19.2 kilobit per second or 115.2 kilobit per second. For example, if the baud rate is 9.6 kilobit per second, then period of 1 bit is about 0.104 milliseconds. This is an example for UART data frame when sending or receiving the ASCII capital A character. The data frame settings is 8 and 1, which means 8 data bit, no parity, and 1 stop bit. Here, the LSB of ASCII capital A will be sent first after the start bit. The logic 1 and 0 of UART data frame can be represented by using several voltage representation. For example, TTL, which means 5 volts for logic 1 and 0 volts for logic 0. And there is also LVTTL or low voltage TTL, which means logic 1 is 3.3 volts and logic 0 is 0 volts. Another commonly used voltage level is RS232. In this logic level, 0 is represented as positive voltage between plus 3 volt and plus 15 volt, and 1 is represented as negative voltage between minus 3 volt and minus 15 volt. Because of there are several voltages for UART, then you must know which voltage level that is used on your device. In case for STM32, the voltage level is LVTTL or 3.3 volt. And then, to connect your STM32 to PC, you need a voltage level converter. If you use PC that has DB9 port on your motherboard, then you can use this module to convert from LVTTL to RS232 voltage. This kind of module is usually used MAX232 IC for TTL or MAX3232 IC for LVTTL. If you use a laptop or your PC doesn't have a DB9 port, then you can use LVTTL to USB converter module, which is usually based on FPGA IC. This is the connection diagram from your STM32 to PC. There are 3 pins that must be connected from your STM32 to your voltage converter module, which are TX, RX, and ground. The TX and RX are cross-connected, which means that the TX of the STM32 is connected to the RX of converter module, and the RX of STM32 is connected to the TX of converter module. On some module, the TX pin might be labeled as RX, and RX is labeled as TX. So you should check this if your converter module doesn't transmit or receive anything to or from PC. And then in PC, you should use a serial monitor software in order to write or read data from or to your STM32. Okay, in this demo, I will show you two examples. In example 1, I will show you how to configure UART in polling mode. And in example 2, I will show you how to convert integer and real number to string for UART transmission. Okay, let's begin with example 1. In this example, I will show you a simple program for turn on and turn off an LED from PC. In QPMX, you can configure the system debug and then the RCC. After that, you can enable the UART. In this case, I will use UART2. Select the mode to asynchronous, and then after that, we have to configure one GPIO as output for LED. In clock configuration tab, you can set the sysclock to your desired value. In configuration tab, you can go to GPIO, and then you can set your GPIO mode. After that, you can go to UART. In this window, you can configure the baud rate, data bits, parity bit, and stop bits. For this example, I will use the default settings. Click OK, and then you can generate the code. Here, in main.c file, I have marked all of the codes that I have added to this project. You can add or remove this mark by using this button or by pressing Ctrl F2. Here you have to add a library string.h, and then here you can add two array variables. This array is declared with constant keyword, so it will be stored in flash memory instead of SRAM. And then here in main loop, this line is used to transmit the initial message to PC with 1 millisecond timeout. After that, this line is used to receive data from PC with 5 second timeout. So you have 5 seconds to enter the command from your PC. In this line, the receive command is compared by using string compare function. If the command is equal to LED1, then turn on the LED and also transmit this message to PC. If the command is equal to LED0, then turn off the LED and also transmit this message to PC. Here, there is also a function called strlen. This function is used to get how many bytes does the message variable has. The strlen and string compare function is defined in string.h library. This is the result. In serial monitor, this initial message will be printed every 5 seconds. When I send the LED1 command, the LED will be on, and this message will be printed, which indicates that the LED is on. And then, when I send the LED0 command, the LED will be off, and the LED is off status will be printed. Okay, in example 2, the CubeMX configuration is the same as previous example. In main.c file, you can add these codes. Here, there are two numbers, integer and real, that will be sent to PC by using UART. But before that, we must convert this data type, integer and double, to array of characters, because this function, HAL UART transmit, can only transmit characters, not integer not double. In order to do that, you have to create a buffer that will store the characters, for example, STF buffer. And then, by using this function, sprintf, the integer number will be converted to array of characters. This format, %d, is for integer number in decimal. Here, another example to print this number to hexadecimal by using %x format. To convert real number You can use %f format, for example, %.2f, which means that the real number will be rounded to 2 decimal places. This sprintf function is defined in string.h library. This is the result. After you download and run the code, the numbers will be printed to serial monitor. This is the integer number in decimal, and this is in hexadecimal, and this is the real number that has been rounded to 2 decimal places. Okay, this is the end of this lecture. In this lecture, you have learned how to configure UART in polling mode and how to do a data type conversion for UART transmission. Thank you for watching and see you in the next lecture. Goodbye.